Alright, here we are where we left off on the first part of this Let's Play. I actually had a technical problem. I went through and recorded the next section, but when I got ready to edit it, something was up with the frame rate and it was kind of weird, so this is actually not the same character. We actually created a new one based on the last one, as best as I could remember. Turns out I got a few things wrong. The name was Winfred. Now we have Minifred, or Minifred as it looks. And I probably leveled the character the same, but for the most part we're in the same spot, so it shouldn't be too much confusion. I think what I want to do before we move on is use some of these souls items we've got and level up a little bit. Okay, so we've got them all in our item box. Let me just use some of these. And we'll rush forward into the unexplored beyond. Okay. That puts us at 900. I'm not sure what we need to level up at this point. Let's see. We can level up, give us about one level here. I think let's go dexterity. I'm not sure what weapons we're going to encounter in the next section, what their requirements are, but let's just try to be prepared for that. And then these, so let's go ahead and see what these are worth. So that's 400. We still can get another level out of this. That beautiful specular shine on the shield. You get the sky HDR reflection type map there, and then you've got the orange fire glowing on the shield there. And the whole time you can see that. Oh, there they are together. You can see the creases and dents in it, things like that. It's pretty cool. Level up. And let's go for vitality. That's only at 12 at this point. Okay, so we'll just try to reach our minimum requirements for each weapon that we want to wield within reason. And besides that, we'll probably, for the most part, for the time being, just go for vitality and endurance for a while. But we'll see, it's going to be a changing situation, so. Take that. What are you doing? Alright, that was interesting. Of course, now I've got Home Dude on my case down there. Because I wasn't thinking, and. Like I said, I wasn't thinking. Oh, rats. Let's try that again. That's embarrassing. Try not to be so sloppy about it this time. Come on. Oh, man. Off with your head. Ooh. Okay. Man. Looking to have it happen again, aren't I? That's no good. Get out of here. Alright, got guys falling off the cliff all over the place. Hollow Warrior Armor. Check out the stats on that. And you. Get at it. Alright, well, you know, I thought for a second he was going to jump off the ledge there. Let's kick him off. Alright, and we're gonna be careful this time. Heck, let me go ahead and collect these souls before I do anything stupid and walk off the cliff again or some nonsense like that. Whoa, speaking of some nonsense, I about did myself in there. Ring of Sacrifice. Probably what'll happen is I'll hold on to that until the end game, because that's. I usually end up porting those. The long winding staircase. Okay, so this is interesting to me. So there's a chasm down there where we have the Valley of the Drakes and all that stuff. So Firelink Shrine is on one side, and then you've got Undead Burg. Well, some of Undead Burg's on this side with us, and then some's on the other side. So this is the first time we're gonna cross over it. is out this aqueduct here. So we cross over the chasm. That's just interesting to try to keep track of the layout of the area. Try to keep in mind where things are. So this is, there's Firelink Shrine down there. There's the far distance, beautiful vista back there. And here's a rat. I'm gonna chop him. Got him in one blow, that was nice. So we cross over this chasm into the undead Burg. Ah. It's funny with these games too, because you play it's like in Mario, the old Mario games. You play the first world so much more often, because it's, you know, you start there. So every run that you start that doesn't, you don't see through to the end, you get more practice on the beginning of the game than you do on the eventual end of the game. And so these areas are so familiar. In fact, so familiar that sometimes you get foolish and get yourself killed for stupid reasons. And these guys too apparently aren't taking the jobs very seriously. You go ahead and warn your friends over there. Thank you, sir. I hit the wrong guy. All's well that ends well. We're so surrounded by dummies here. Hmm. Delicious. Praise the Lord. Oh, only one at a time here. What are you doing? Get out of here. You're coming up the ladder with me. Alright, so this is the top of that aqueduct we came across, and we're in the Undead Burg now. On the opposite side of the ravine chasm area that Firelink Shrine is on. And there's the part of the chasm down there. In fact, there's a there's like a cave or something down there. I don't know what that is. Wish I had a good camera angle. Let's see. There we go. Oh, well, come on. So I wonder if that's anything. Doop 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 doop. Welcome to the circus, welcome to the circus. Chop you in the head with an axe. Ooh, calm down. Alright. Synchronized dying. We got a chain of bodies there. I doubt this shield will be worth more than the shield we've got now. Let's check it out anyway. Does the spider shield... Well, it does block 100% damage, so that's actually not bad. Why is it... Okay. So this is the wooden shield. The only advantage is it has... It looks like it has better lightning resistance. It has worse stability. Oh, and it's lighter. It's half as heavy, so... You all.
Well now, you seem to have your wits about you. Then you are a welcome customer. I trade for souls. Everything's for sale.
Everything's for sale. Let's see. Fire bombs. Let's get the residence key. And let's see. Maybe. I'm kind of interested in getting a ranged weapon. Although we can get a free crossbow, but I don't know if that's going to do the trick or not. Since we're strength, let's check the stats on these. So that scales better with strength. That scales excellently with strength. And that one not so much, but it's better base damage. Which I think right now... right now that's actually worth a little more damage. But our axe is pretty good too. Scimitar. Let's just go with the key right now. We can always come back. You know, wait, hold on a second. We're a bandit. We may not need that key. We might have the master key. Okay, no we don't. Are we not a bandit? I thought we were. What are we? Doesn't say. Let's do the key. Resonance key. Costs us 1,000 souls. Hey, get out of here.
What's the matter?
That was poorly timed. Should have known better. Let's go ahead and go for this this crossbow. See if we can make this jump in the first attempt. And there we go. So we're up here. Ooh. I don't know if I can fall through that spot in the floor. If I could, I almost did. Let's try. Find out right now. Okay, so apparently it's just a phony. Okay, so this cross this bridge up here. We're gonna be up there before too long. In fact, let's see this side over here. Let's see. Wait, I think this side over here includes the Undead Parish. This side over here. Not sure. One of the sides has the sunlight altar area in it. Waistcloth. So we're piecing together the Hollow Warrior armor, which probably we won't be using, but we might get hold of one of those shields. top with your head. Yeah, when we get up to the top of that bridge, let's piece out which side is... Let's piece together which side is what. Get a little turned around there. See if this guy will close the door for us. No. You just stay out there and throw firebombs. Alright, so there's a gold pine resin. Let's see if he... No, he didn't. Sometimes he closes the door. I just thought that was a nice, polite thing to do. Firebombs are another thing that I tend to kind of hoard. I don't use them very often. Yeah, this is gonna be the end of this fight. Not careful. Fast guy. Let's try it again. And, okay, I thought I was gonna hit that pillar there. So we managed to survive. We're actually still running on bonus Estus flask from the first. He killed himself from the first from the Firelink Shrine. We got more than five right now. So we can't open that door. Let's head on up. Engage in our first. Well, actually, our second boss battle, our first non-tutorial boss battle. This area is cool. It's a really sunlit kind of top of the wall here. And so we were just down there fighting those dudes that nearly finished me off. Man, I gotta work on my timing. You gotta work on their timing too. So let's see if we can't get a view from up here. So there's the bridge that was going across. We were down there, and okay, on the right side over here is the parish, because in the distance there on the big brown building, you can see that's, we're gonna be there later. Here's the parish and the church. And then on the left side over here... Okay, so this is just the edge of the wall over here. Okay. So you can see then we're going to fight the Taurus Demon up here. Right away. Forthwith. See if we can't make short work of him. Make your launch. I deserve that one. That's the lighting up here is really cool. Wouldn't be surprised if he could do damage to us through this shield. Take that wall. Yeah, so he just did damage through the shield right there. So I'll probably need to back up, get a little drink going. I'll just do it right here in front of him. Apparently, let's taunt him if we can, right? Oh, you're not so bad. Come on. Not such a bad guy. You know you got a soft spot. Missed. So you miss. Whack at him. Come on, getting a two-handed strong attack on him here. Well, let me get back up a bit. It's giving me a headache. Let me roll into his attack. There we go, we actually got a hit him that time. That was an improvement over... Ooh, I'm gonna walk off the edge. Nice big gaping hole there, I'm gonna stand next to it. Too, because this mod, as I mentioned earlier, gives me these this yellow bar down here, which doesn't give me a percentage idea of, you know, how much damage I've done to him. Although we can see that he's clearly getting pretty low. Get away from that nice window there in the wall. Nice not to fall off. It's all about, really about stamina. Stamina management. Largely, anyway. We've seen that he can do some damage through the shield, but without the shield, we would have been finished off. You know, far earlier. Alright.
Victory achieved!
So, down there, we're about to be down there. On that side. So this is the outer part of pretty much the playable game area, as far as I can tell. This is the edge of the wall in the city area. So now we're in the tower at the end of the bridge that we looked at earlier. About to say hello to our first NPC character, or NPC that we kind of follow through the game, I guess, that you can summon. Standing out here enjoying this beautiful view.
Ah, hello. You don't look hollow, far from it. I am Solaire of Astora, an adherent of the Lord of Sunlight. Now that I am undead, I have come to this great land, the birthplace of Lord Gwyn, to seek my very own son. You find that strange? Well, you should. No need to hide your reaction. I get that look all the time. Oh, aha. So I didn't scare you. I have a proposition, if you have a moment. The way I...
You couldn't scare me, Solaire.
...appear to be intertwined. In a land brimming with hollows, could that really be mere chance? So what do you say? Why not help one another on this lonely journey? This pleases me greatly. Well then, take this.
Right.
The realm is strange beings in a strange
land. What a friendly guy.
The flow of time itself is convoluted, with heroes centuries old phasing in and out. The very fabric wavers, and relations shift and obscure. There's no telling how much longer your world and mine will remain in contact. But use this to summon one another as spirits, cross the gaps between the worlds, and engage in jolly cooperation. Of course, we are not the only ones engaged in this. But I am a warrior of the sun. Spot my summon signature easily by its brilliant aura. If you miss it, you must be blind.
Indeed.
Oh, hello there. I will stay behind to gaze at the sun. The sun is a wondrous body, like a magnificent father. If only I could be so grossly incandescent.
Solaire, I'm sure I have no idea what you're talking about, but you seem like a nice enough guy. And this is, now here we are running across the top of the bridge that we were looking at earlier. This is the, I guess, toward the undead parish side. And let's go ahead and connect this shortcut here. This is one of the great things about the level design in these games. You just get these nice shortcuts. So you work hard, and then you unlock a link between two areas, so next time it's a little shorter, a little faster. It's a little prize you get. We've got 5,000 souls to level up with. Let's go ahead and do that. I think I want strength to 16, dexterity to 12, and then the rest, let's go ahead and put into vitality and endurance. See if that gives us enough. There's a claymore up here, and there's a halberd, and I just want to have options when it comes to weapons. I'm not sure what the stats on those requirements on those are exactly, but we'll take a look at it. Hopefully we'll be close or right on. Be nice. Alright. So we can go this way, but let's try, because I want to try to get the claymore and whatnot. See if we can keep moving the tops of our heads torch there, but whoa! Or our butts charred. Oh man. Well, don't have anything to throw at him equipped. Don't wanna, while we're here. Bon voyage, fair dragon. Come out here and collect our goodies. Including but not limited to a claymore. Pretty sure we can wield this guy, but I'm not sure what the scaling. That's cool, you see him. Saw him off there. Yeah, there he goes. In the background there. He's really leaving. You really gone this time. He'll be back. This, like I mentioned earlier, I believe this is the Sunlight Altar. There's a way to get Solaire to meet him out here. I'm not sure. I've never done it. I don't know if you don't talk to him at the previous point, if he'll meet you out here, or what causes him to show up out here. But I've never seen him myself out there. Okay, I think that's probably a good spot for this, to end this one. In the next one, we will head toward the church and maybe take on the gargoyles. We shall see.